Willie Waffle standing by. Good morning, Willie. Good morning. You're live.
Well, good morning, everybody.
We thought we'd start a fight like on The View. Could we get something going? Did you?
Oh, well, yeah, I could get something going. You know, I sent you an email, amazing facts, and you didn't even respond.
Oh, I didn't see it.
Yeah, I saw this. I thought I responded,
You didn't even respond, Andrew.
What did you send me? I didn't see it.
I found out Squeaky Fromme lives in Marcy.
Oh, that's absolutely true. Yes.
Whoa! How did I not know this?
And do you know where our studio is in Marcy?
Yeah.
She's a frequent guest, Willie.
Actually,
yeah, you just have to wear a bulletproof jacket when she comes around.
Actually, we wouldn't even know, right? I mean, if she were to walk in and pick up a birthday cake or something or win the free money question, we wouldn't know.
And by the
happy
way,
happy birthday to Squeaky Fromme.
Willie, don't be joking like that. We have to live here, okay? You're far away.
Right.
So don't be cracking jokes like that here.
Yeah.
She's in earshot.
I do have to tell you that Angelo is one of our producers, and he is you're going to be a senior, right, in high school. And I had told his mom, I said, I've given him his big job. He's got to get Squeaky Fromme and, get her on the air. And his mother said, he can do anything, but he can't do that.
Yeah.
No.
Wise advice from mother.
Yeah.
Of all people who could do it, I think Angelo could.
I do. And I have to tell you, we did reach out, and we were told no. in a way that made was it you or who?
No, I think so.
Steph, somebody was trying to book it. It might have been Christine, and they were told whoever it was told no in a way that they're like, I didn't even follow up with a question.
Like don't even ask again ever again.
Yeah. There was the sound and the.
I think the OD actually wrote a story on this that they had went to a. I don't know if it was a Walmart or some convenience store or something, and there was a guy like security, like a biker guy, and was like,
"Yes."
Told the reporter,
"Don't even think about
don't
it.
Even
yeah,
you don't
yeah." So there you go, Willie. And there's always something new out there, isn't there?
There really is. This is amazing.
All right,
this is why we love the world.
I want to ask you just some quickies. It's playing here now, and you said still. I heard the Gotti movie, played by John Travolta, by the way.
Yeah.
I heard it's awful. Do you concur?
Oh, yeah. I have not even had a chance to see it because it didn't even play anywhere near me here in Binghamton. And you know, the word is it is the worst movie ever made.
Yeah.
And this
that is
from
I'm
a guy
that.
Who also made that Scientology movie years ago, okay? Yeah. So, the deal is the movie was just a turmoil. You know, they went through several directors. They went through a couple of different production companies. At one point, they were going to try to release it last December to try to make it an Oscar contender. And then it was pulled at the last minute.
What?
And they were going to do it as an on-demand release. And then they decided they wanted to put it into the theaters. And it's just been up and down for years and years. And Travolta, you know, God love him, keeps telling everybody it's this great performance and how much he loves the movie, and it turns out it's just dreadful.
Yeah. It's funny, when I asked Willie to check on this movie, there were two movies. One was a Mr. Rogers movie, the other was Gotti. Spellcheck changed the name of Gotti. Even Spellcheck doesn't want you to say that name because for fear of, I don't know,
retribution.
Getting backspaced or something. Somehow it changed the letter from Gotti to an H, and it came out Hottie. And Willie's like, I've heard of the Mr. Rogers movie, but that Hottie movie, I
oh my God, John Travolta was playing
Hottie.
That was
pay per view. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Okay, so that one is terrible. What about Mr. Rogers?
You know, Mr. Rogers is considered probably the best documentary of the year.
Wow.
And this is another one. It's playing in about 800 theaters, so it's not playing everywhere. And so, you know, people have been just raving about the great story, the wonderful, you know, the wonderful way that Mr. Rogers confronted so many social issues for children in a way that they could understand and embrace. And you're going to hear a lot about this movie when it comes Oscar time. I think they're going to put a big push on. I think it's got a major chance at being the documentary winner when we get to that part.
Okay, so now that we've talked about all this other stuff, I don't have time for the other two movies. But you can quickly, I've got like 15 seconds. Equalizer 2, how many waffles?
1.5 waffles.
Yeah.
And
no
Mama Mia 2.
You know, it's so much fun, I got to say 3 waffles.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
Sequel to, I wish we had
my daughter and wife are going to love that. All right, Willie, thanks, man. We appreciate it. We'll do it again next week.
All right, talk to you next week.
Yeah, we got caught up. 3 waffles for Mamma Mia 2. How about that?